Welcome to my initial introductory episode of Let's Play Advanced Dungeons & Dragons, which I won't say that part in the future, but that is officially part of the name, Pool of Radiance. This was the first game in the Gold Box series of games. My ultimate goal for this would be to do all of these games as part of the same series with the same characters. So that's four games, and there are also other games that I could potentially export the same characters to. I'm not going to be using these characters. This is I just loaded up the party that comes with the game, so there's automatically a save. And so some of the funny things about this game, I mean, it's going to be a definite project to do because there's no music, so I'm just going to add some music into this video, so whatever you're hearing is inorganic with the game. So, and then on top of that, this is one of those early games where a lot of the text wasn't actually included in the game, so it's every once in a while the game refers you to the adventurer's journal, and so I'm gonna have to deal with that. I'm probably gonna read those entries out loud, which is going to be fun. So the story of this game is right now I'm in New Flan. I can press area, I can look at the map, so I guess that gives you a general beginning idea of what New Flan looks like. This is the beginnings of a city that was built on the ruins of an older city of Flan, which has a lot of history. I mean, there were a lot of eras, and basically through hubris and just circumstances being what they were, the previous civilization fell, the town was taken over by monsters and evil forces for a really long time, and just now this intrepid group of people, not our party members, but you know, all the people who now live here, came in and cleared out just this section of town that we see on our map and that we can cruise around here in. So they've cleared that out, and our mission is A, to clear out more sections of the city, and B, ultimately, to discover the source of basically the hostile elements. Who's in charge, you know? Basically, the plot of the game is, who is Kaiser Sose? So that's what we're here to find out, who is Kaiser Sose. I guess I kind of feel satisfied with that as a basic introduction to the game. I'm playing the PC version. The graphics aren't great, but I mean, if you're gonna look at early games, there are worse graphics, and you know, there are actually worse settings that I could do. The sound that I have is PC sound, so it should give sound effects in game and stuff. Right over here is where we get all our quests from. Well, actually, it's where we turn quests into. The quests are just sort of out there. You can accomplish them. Not all of them, but a lot of them are. Especially in the beginning. Basically, you just go up, kill some monsters and come back, and you might get a reward. Here's the training hall. Those are probably the two most important places at the moment. I'm probably going to assume that you have some familiarity with Dungeons & Dragons. I might explain some things, but it's a lot to get into. I'm not going to like read the whole rule book. Yeah, so basically, the questions that I have are, it's probably going to be a couple of weeks before I really get started on doing these, because I still have to finish up the Let's Plays that I have going, and sort of prepare for this. So let me know what kind of music you might like to hear in the game, because I'm going to have to use my own music, and let me know if there's any kinds of race or race class combinations you'd like to see. Basically, the options are for race. Hold on. Okay. The options are dwarf, elf, gnome, half-elf, halfling, human. And this is pretty much all the classes in cleric, fighter, magic user, thief. Those are the basic ones. And then you have these, the hybrids that you can see here. In the past, personally, I always played with human because there are level restrictions on pretty much all of the other races, except I think for thieves. Thieves don't have any restrictions on level. But I think it would be kind of neat to just do something a little bit different. So, yeah, give me some suggestions. I'm also going to do some research in terms of determining what would be the most advantageous in the long run. Because if I'm going to do all of them, then I want characters who are going to be strong in Pooled Darkness, which is the fourth one. So, yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. Icons, yada yada yada. I'm not sure if I'm gonna record character creation. That could be really boring. We'll see. Anyway, yeah, so that's pretty much the primer and the introduction. So let me know. I don't actually expect to get any responses, but it would be nice if you guys chimed in and let me know what, sort of, if any sort of characters you'd like to see, what kind of music you might like to hear. Obviously, I'm not going to play any, like, Metallica or anything. Not that I have anything against it, I love Metallica, but chances are, like, my sound will be turned off or something, and it won't work out. And it also just kind of would be a little funky. So, yeah, anyway, that's it for now. So I look forward to doing this Let's Play, and, I guess you'll see more later.